Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to John's Model Making. Today we got the second issue of Build the Titanic. This is picked up from the news agency. It's on a large card just like the first issue. It gives all the information just the same as the first issue. Apparently issue 3 is on sale in 2 weeks time at the standard price of $9.99. This issue we got hull parts, screwdriver, and there we have the Titanic. And obviously the magazine, which is brilliant. I received notification today from Hachette about my subscription. Issues 1 and 2 are on the way. 3 and 4 are going to be next month. There's no free gift with 1 and 2. Apparently there's a delay on that, and that will be arriving next month with issues 3 and 4. Being a subscriber, I get issue 3 free. Issue 4 is at $9.99, and there's 2 a month up until at least the first 8 issues, and then after that it should be going monthly. There has been some conflicting information on whether it's all after issue 8 or from issue 10, so we'll just have to wait and see where that's concerned. But anyway, let's have a look at these parts that we got today, so let's get on with the build. Okay, so issue 2, here we have the parts. We have the porthole section upper and lower. We got a connecting plate and the nameplate, the Titanic. We got a three screwdriver, and we get 7 AM screws. So just get a nice cushion, and we can connect all these parts together. Now we'll have a look at the quality of these parts as well. The nameplate we don't actually do anything with today, keep that for later in the build. Now that looks pretty good to me. Show it on the camera. There we go. Very nice. Don't see any blemishes, any marks on that. I've been asked to think it's overemphasized, all these panels. But I do like it. Obviously I've never seen the ship, so all my pictures, that looks equally as good. Beautiful. Now basically them two go together like that, and that connecting plate goes on there. So let's put this together. I'm not going to use that screwdriver, it looks far too small. And a collection of all these free gift screwdrivers, they don't last very long, so I'll always stick with the wearer. There we go. Get that lined up. Nice and tight. Excellent. Just like that. Brilliant. Now this, I believe, goes there like that. And we have 5. Do we put one there? I don't think we do. 1, 2, 3, 4 screws to fit. I don't know whether this is a change for Hachette to do what they're doing with these plates, because I noticed with the Bismarck they use metal plates. This is plastic, this one, and it does cover a greater area, so hopefully they've done that to give it a bit more solidity, better connectivity, because I think it did suffer from gaps. I've not built the Bismarck, just watched other people's videos. Last one. Oh, Excellent. There we go. Leave that cushion there. That looks brilliant. I don't see any gaps there anywhere. Fantastic. And the nameplate. Where that goes there, I'd imagine. At a later date. Like that. Brilliant. Okie dokie. Let's have a look at this magazine again. Now, there's a magazine. That's on one side. Now, I did want to draw people's attention to this advertisement card that was inside. Obviously, it's for exclusive offer for premium subscribers. You get the case and the base for $10.99 a month, but also you can subscribe from issue 3 and you get issue 4 free, and then you do get all the subscription free gifts that come with it: the pocket watch, screwdriver set, the free issue, which would be issue 4, and the tin poster and the binder. So that's a brilliant offer as well. If you're still much into the Titanic, because I know that a lot of people have got it from the news agents 1 and 2. I don't know why Partway's companies put it into the news agents before subscribers, but there we have Titanic, the ship, the legend. It can be a bit frustrating, like I said earlier, but my subscription 1 and 2 is on its way. Expected in the next couple of weeks. Well, it'll be allocated at the weekend, and I should get it before the 28th. Now, in that time, issue 3 will be out at the newsagents, but I won't be picking it up, simply because I'll get that next month with the free subscription gift. So anyway, let's have a look at the magazine. We have first page of Titanic tragedy. Less than 45 minutes after striking the iceberg, it became clear that the great ship could not survive, despite the compartments being separated by watertight bulkheads. That article goes on for 3 pages, and on the third page there's a picture of a clarinet, a mystery of the clarinet. The famous Titanic bands, which were legendary for the dramatic role they played during the shipwreck, did not have a clarinet player. Among the 8 musicians who played in a trio and a quintet were string players and a pianist, but no woodwind players. In a ship with over 2,000 people on board, it is likely there will be some other musician, a professional travelling overseas, or an amateur simply wanting to liven up the long voyage by entertaining friends, perhaps in the salons that were popular with second and third class passengers. However, there is no record of the owner, but this clarinet survived and is now part of Titanic memorabilia. Also, main picture of the ship. This, well, it's a drawing from a newspaper at the time. It shows the deck arrangement, the length of the gash, and the gradual flooding of the hull. Then we have J. Bruce Ismay, the owner. Soon after the sinking of Titanic, rumours began to circulate about the behaviour of one of the survivors. Following an investigation, his reputation was ruined forever. They printed a boat twice. I remember Bruce Ismay. I think he was played by Jonathan Hyde in the film Titanic. And it does, do remember seeing him getting into the boat, the last lifeboat. And he didn't look comfortable then, but that was a film. Anyway, that is a very good article on him, and it does tell you everything that, not everything, but how it affected him and his career after the Titanic had sunk. And he had a lot of making up to do, if all is true, but we never know, do we, fully? And on the next page we have Hot Cuisine Italian Style. There was a choice of 4 dining areas for first class passengers on board Titanic, including the exclusive a la carte restaurant, which was staffed predominantly by Italians. Excellent stuff. That goes on for 3 pages. Then we have the instructions on the back 2 pages, which you've already seen. Well, there's not a great lot to do, but there we go. That is it. That is issue two complete. That is going to look fantastic. I'm really impressed with that. That plastic panel there as well, connecting panel, interconnecting panel. It's a better idea than what I've seen on the Bismarck anyway. Fantastic. Brilliant. Just thinking, how many years? What is it? 3 years? I love a big ship like this. Excellent. Anyway, if you did enjoy that, give us a big thumbs up. And I'll see you see you next month. But anyway, thanks for watching. Take care and see you soon. Bye for now.